This was a note that Morgan wrote to us, and this is going to embarrass her again, but that's what I'm good for. I'm really good at embarrassing things. And this is what she wrote to me. Dear Mom and Dad, words cannot describe how thankful I am to you two today. Thank you for setting me up for a lifetime of success. Even though I may not always realize it, the influences you have surrounded me with have made me the woman I am today. I could not be any more proud of how Morgan has turned out and the woman that she is today. And I'm so grateful that Derek is that part of her life now, the other half.
I could not think of a happier occasion that I get to stand up and tell a story about my sister. She's one of the people I love most in the entire world. But as great of friends we are, you know, we do have, for kids, I suppose, a fairly significant age gap. She is 5 years older than me. So as close of friends as we are, you know, I felt a lot of times you could be like almost a third parent to me. And I learned so much from you over the years. No, she really could. And, you know, some of the best lessons I learned from you is I learned that it's never a bad thing to be the hardest working person in the room. No matter what you do, you take it so seriously. You have an incredible work ethic. And I'm sure it's one of the most important things Derek admires about you.
Derek has been there for all of my highs and my lows. He's the first person I call when I have something exciting to share, and I simply just need advice. And I'm so grateful for that. He is the most humble, compassionate, kind, hardworking, and genuine person that I know. He has a gift of making anyone he meets feel like they're the most important person in the room. That's because he truly means it. It's not an act. There's no fakeness about you, Derek. Morgan, from the moment I met you, I knew you were the one for my brother. You're intelligent, family-oriented, kind, compassionate. Everything I could ever want from my brother.
Oh, look at her. My baby girl.
You look so handsome.
You look beautiful, my little girl.
You
look beautiful.
Thank you.
You're like all grown up.
I am.
Derek, when I was a little girl, I spent hours dreaming about the man I was going to marry someday. Here we go. Okay. While watching sunsets on Grandma and Grandpa's hammock or looking up at the stars in my backyard on Fox Ridge Circle, I would often lay there and think, I wonder what he's like, and I wonder what he's doing right now. I knew if I were to ever find the one, that he would be strong, intelligent, and competent, while at the same time being kind, compassionate, and a man of his word.
My dearest Morgan, happy wedding day to the most stunningly beautiful bride in the world, who, by way of divine intervention, I am lucky enough to call mine. I'm completely overwhelmed by the fact that I get to marry you, and I can't begin to tell you how ecstatic I am that today is finally here. I've waited my entire life for you, and I knew from the moment we met that you were the one. If you're anything like me, your heart is beating out of your chest right now. After all, this is the culmination of 1 year's worth of tireless planning, organizing, and orchestrating every fine detail of our wedding to perfection. More importantly, we are both making the commitment of a lifetime.
Through life experiences and as time continued to pass, I came to believe that my dreams were foolish and unreasonable. Many along the way would tell me, you can't have it all. Some even encouraged me to settle. But something inside of me wouldn't allow it. Even if it was just a small glimmer of hope, I held on and waited for the chance that you were still out there. I wanted nothing less than my soulmate and true love. I kept saying to my friends and family, I know I'll know when I know. And just when I least expected it, you walked into the room. On February 1st, 2017, the world stopped turning for a moment as you completely took my breath away.
Your laugh, your smile, your wit, your complete and utter positivity, your sincerity, and your devotion to your friends, your family, and your faith were all the evidence I needed to prove that I absolutely had to make you my wife. And your remarkable beauty just takes it over the top. You are my ultimate desire. Since we met on that cold February night, I've dreamt about the day I would stand at the altar with you before our most beloved family and friends, and before God to take your hand in marriage. When we first met, that day seemed so far away, but 578 days later, that day is today.
You are my heart's desire, my kindred spirit, and the deepest love I will ever know on this earth. For all of my days, I will be the arms that hold you, the one to wipe away your happy and sad tears, and will continually remind you that you are the light of my life. I will also challenge you, grow with you, and stand beside you as we weather life storms. I promise to daily seek the Lord with you every day as we live our lives in gratitude for the love he has shown us. This love was worth the wait, and if I had to do it all over again, I would wait another lifetime for you. Thank you for being everything and more than I ever dreamed possible. My heart is yours forever. I can't wait to see you waiting for me at the end of the aisle. All of my love, Morgan.
Morgan, the minute those doors opened and you started walking through, Derek has forgotten everything he's ever learned. He's seeing my lips move right now, but he's not really hearing because he's thinking of you, and he should be. And Derek, the moment Morgan saw you waiting here for her, her mind was full of a thousand thoughts because she's dreamed and imagined what this moment will look like for some time. For those of us who know you both, it's obvious that you love each other. And recently, I asked you both what you love most about the other. And she did send me the one thing she loved most as she thought about it. What she loves most about you is that she said you are equally as logical and intelligent as you are kind and compassionate. And Morgan, I asked Derek what he loved most about you. That had a lot in it, just even this one sentence. He mentioned your laugh, your smile, your wit, your complete and utter positivity, your sincerity, and your devotion to your friends, family, and faith. Those of us who know you see those qualities. And now unto you and all who are present, may this blessing come upon you, that you be in love, grow in love, stand in love, and act by love through our solid rock, Jesus Christ, both now and forevermore. By the authority committed to me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ and the laws of the state of Ohio, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Derek, the time is here. You can kiss your bride. It is now my privilege to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Derek Hemp.
You know, one wonders who and what kind of a person would share the rest of their lives, you know, with Morgan, and it's kind of an interesting thought in itself, and we just want you to know that we could not be happier or just more content with the commitment that you are now one, and we're so happy. Thank you.
You know, Derek, I am so proud that you are the one that she saw fit to bring home. You treat my sister with such sincerity, such tenderness, such attentiveness, such passion. I could not be more proud to call somebody my brother than you.
I had kind of an illness a couple of years ago. I don't know how many of you guys know this or not, but I was in the hospital for about 10 days. I was diagnosed with leukemia, and a real special thing to me was I had to have something, an IV put in my neck this one night and stuff like that, and things weren't looking too good. Morgan told me, she goes, "Dad, I prayed that night that you would be here to walk me down the aisle." And it meant the world to me. It meant the world to me. And I made it through, and I'm here, and I'm ready to dance tonight. So, yeah.
Morgan and I used to have a nickname for each other, and we called ourselves the co-presidents of the Single for Life Club. And Morgan, I cannot think of a happier time, occasion, venue to celebrate your retirement. I will watch the throne. I love you both so much.